Good afternoon, everyone. Disturbing new details uncovered today about a Marshalltown murder.
As Vanessa Ping reports, we're learning what tipped off police and what happened to the victim. We want to caution you, the details of this story not appropriate for younger viewers.
It was a voicemail from the suspect that led police to the body of David Warnell of Garwin. They found his body here, a single-story house at 502 North 4th Avenue on October 1st. According to a recently unsealed search warrant application, an informant told police he or she had received a phone message from 30-year-old Jeremy Garden of Marshalltown. Documents say someone also says something about stabbing someone in the heart and also burning a couch. Someone then says something about pulling a trigger, it going pow, and then that he had shot someone in the head. The documents go on to say police conducted surveillance on Garden at his home the day Warnell's body was found. And at around 11:15 hours, Jeremy had carried trash out of the rear of the residence and set it outside. Police later retrieved the trash bags they saw him carry outside and found body parts. According to court documents, some of the things found in connection with the murder were what appears to be human fingers, teeth, and a tattoo on a piece of skin that looked to be cut off a person. All things that could be used to identify someone. We did knock on the door of the house and try to get in contact with the people inside, but no one answered. And we also spoke to neighbors who did not want to go on camera, but they tell us it's scary and unusual that such a horrific crime could have happened in their neighborhood. Garten is charged with first-degree murder and abuse of a corpse in the death of Warnell. 55-year-old Max Nelson Jr. is also charged in the case as an accessory. They have both pled not guilty, and their trials are scheduled for early December. Garten's lawyer, Story County Public Defender Paul Rounds, declined to go on camera, and Marshall County Attorney Jennifer Miller was unavailable for an interview.
Vanessa Ping, thank you very much.